get ready to match the stars. Ron Palillo, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Wally, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76.
My dear. Is everything... Holy mackerel.
I hope we don't have a frost tonight.
No. We wouldn't on a freezer fruit, would we?
Tony's clapping.
He loves this show.
Boy, are you all quite ready?
You're coughing. You must be ready.
Yes.
I don't know why I have repressed the name of the character you play on Welcome Back, Kotter. Refreshing my memory.
Arnold.
Arnold.
Horseshank.
Horseshank. How do you spell that, Ron?
H-O-R-S-H-A-C-K.
Arnold Horseshack.
Yes.
He is a countertenor. He keeps his light hidden under a bushel or a barrel.
He's a singer.
They don't even have countertenors.
Well, they don't have
anymore.
Them anymore.
Yes.
They were very big during the Renaissance, and they haven't written for them since.
Well, we're going to try and do something.
Can we announce now our opera?
What is that?
Charles has just cast me in an opera.
What's that?
What is it? The Barber of Seville?
To play the part of the maid.
I'm bucking for a bigger role, though.
You could play the barber.
It has one aria, and she could be wonderful.
No doubt about it.
It's
Let's say hello to our two players here, Carol Binnick and Tony Taverna. Hey. Now, this lady... What did I tell you? This lady has won $11,900. And she came all the way from North Carolina to be on this program, and her luck has really been holding out. What are you going to do with all that loot, Carol?
Make my husband very happy.
Oh, really? There are ways to do that without money.
Take a dim view of that.
Listen, if we all talk at the same time, you see, it doesn't work, folks. Now, she's being challenged here by Tony Taverna, who's had his first round question. He matched two of our celebrities. And we'll see how she does in a moment or so. But right now, we want to do a little business with you.
He'll do it to you every time.
Now, here we go. Push the button. Reveal the other question in round one. This is all yours, Carol. Listen carefully. Steve had a very strange hair transplant.
Oh. How strange was it,
Doctor? I'll tell you how strange it was. He had the hair removed from his head and transplanted onto his blank. And forever after, he had a... had hair transplanted, removed from his head,
and transplanted
onto his blank.
Very good. I have it there, ready to go.
Oh, dear me.
I already did it.
Okay. No sleight of hand with those cards up there now. Hello, Carol.
Hi.
Steve had this very strange hair transplant. He had the hair removed from his head and transplanted onto his blank.
His bottom.
His bottom.
That's strange.
That is a strange way. Forever after, he was known as Harry Bottom. Yes. Harry Bottom. Got a job at NBC?
Harry Bottom speaking. Hello there, Ron.
Hello. I think that's a very good answer.
You do? Why would you think that?
Oh, Harry Bottom. That's very in these days.
It has a mellifluous flow to it, doesn't it?
Harry Bottom. It cools the throat. However, I put chest.
Harry Chest.
Thank you.
head under his chest.
That's good. One possibility.
You may find this hard to believe, but that's what Jack Klugman did.
Really?
Took the hair from his head and put it on his chest.
No kidding. So he could go, oh.
No, so he could go out and buy a toupee.
Oh. What did you say, Charles? Speaking of transplants.
I didn't want to go along with the rest of the gang, but I have no choice. Chest.
Chest it is. So we have two chests so far, and she's looking for a bottom.
Well, I don't know if I can help you. He was weird, darling, but that's really weird. His chest.
Chest. Okay, yeah, I guess it's... If he wanted to be manly and all that sort of thing, if that is a manly sign indeed.
I think so. It is. Chest.
Chest. Oh. Yes, of course. So that really would have worked great for you. Oh, look at how neat. Well, I was just saw myself on television there.
Get yourself in the monitor,
look
hon.
At that. Yeah, hello.
You vain person.
I am, though. I've never noticed that.
Oh. There's a picture of Fanny up there. You want.
No.
You've never looked so
good in
your life.
I know the difference between Fanny and me. And, what do you say?
I say, I'm sorry. You were looking for a Fanny, but I said chest.
Okay. At this moment, it's 2-0 in favor of Tony. We push the button, go to round two. Tony, you've got a choice again.
A for Antonio.
A for Antonio, as he said last time. All right. Now, he matched two in the first round. Brett does not play, and Charles does not play.
And we're not even Italian.
That's right. Now, the rest of you, listen to this. Barney the Butcher is really absent-minded.
How absent-minded is he?
I shall tell you. Last night, he hung his girlfriend on a hook, then he asked a side of beef to blank him. Oh. Hung his girlfriend on a hook, then he asked a side of beef to blank him. Okay. All right. Very good.
He hung his girlfriend.
Oh,
yes, he hung his girlfriend on a hook.
Hung his girlfriend on a hook, then he asked a side of beef to blank him. Now you're not playing. Don't confuse me. You're not playing, you rascal. All right, everybody ready. Tony Taverna. Barney the Butcher is really absent-minded. Would you like to know how absent-minded?
Yes, I would.
Thank you, Tony, for asking. Last night he hung his girlfriend on a hook. Then he asked a side of beef to blank him.
Kiss him.
Kiss him. Kiss me, you fool. What do you say?
Tony. Kiss.
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 There's one for Tony. Have you got a kiss for Tony?
Well, as they say in Italian, a bacia, bacia,
bacia. For a quarter, I'll let you kiss Tony.
For $1.50, I'll ask you to keep me out of this. No, I thought he was a very proper gentleman. He asked to marry you.
Oh, marry.
Oh, isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
See, none of your chauvinistic.
That's right.
That's charming.
Thank you.
Beautiful, yes. Lovely.
I think she
thought.
Bought it.
All right, Fanny, here we go. What have you got for Tony?
Well, it's obvious.
Joanne, I'll tell you. I said, nice little kiss.
Okay. Not bad, Tony. You got the five. That means if he's got five, this lady's really got her work cut out for her. When we get back from this commercial, match five to buy, six to win. Hurry back. Ready. Okay, here we go. You know what you have to do, Carol?
Five to tie and six to win.
Atta girl. All right, here it goes. Listen carefully now. Howard Cosell's mother said, my son Howard learned to talk at an early age. However, he never learned how to blank. My son Howard learned to talk at an early age. However, he never learned how to blank. You know who Howard Cosell is, don't you, Ron?
Yes. Certainly he does. Are you mad?
Isn't he the man who has a variety show?
There's another
show. He... yes.
Yes.
Formerly. Okay.
That's good.
Good.
No, that's
good.
Bad.
Very good. Very good. Ron, everybody ready over there and ready down here? Carol Biddick, here's the moment of truth for you, my dear.
Howard Cosell's mother said, my son Howard learned to talk at an early age. However, he never learned how to...
Stop.
Stop.
She said stop. What did you say?
He never learned how to shut up his mouth.
Shut up his mouth is a stop and a same thing.
I say it to you. This is an Italian accent. I say it to you. Shut up or your mouth.
Shut up or your mouth. That's two. This moment the score is 5-2. Charles?
This is just simply the king's English to shut up.
Shut up, all right. Score is now 5-3.
Oh,
Joanne.
I'm in love with Tony very much.
Yes.
But it looks good for Carol. Shut up.
Shut up in your mouth. 5-4 the score.
Richard?
This is not a my answer.
This is not a you answer.
First, I was going to say, never learn how to grow hair.
That's
not too bitter to set up.
Why?
Oh, shut up.
Shut up, you mouth. Tie score. What do you got?
Shut up.
Shut up, wins the game. Gotta shake your hand before you go. You're a splendid fellow.
And
we've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being here on Match Game 76.
Ciao!
Tony Taverna. Ciao, Tony.
Ciao, Antonio.
Well, that was a close one.
I know.
You were way behind there, and you had to do it all. You gotta go match six. Okay, and you did it. Now, Carol, you're gonna play your fifth big money super match here. You ready?
I certainly am.
We polled a recent studio audience, Carol, and we got their best response to this. Blank McDonald. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, it's $250. The third gets you $100. Now, let's see who you want over here.
Charles?
Well, there's two goodies. I mean, there's a lot of... Hello, America.
It's only a half-hour show, Charles.
You think so?
Yes, definitely, dear. Yeah, I'll get it for number three.
Or let's go with Brett's boyfriend, Old McDonald.
Old McDonald.
Thank you.
What about Ronald McDonald?
Ronald McDonald.
And Richard?
Richard, you've been called.
Well, no, a nice lady who was a movie actress. Yeah. Marie McDonald.
Marie McDonald.
Number three.
Yes. Okay.
Are you sure you don't mean Jeanette? You don't mean Marie?
No, I don't mean Jeanette at all.
Well, don't.
Oh, all right, blue eyes. There's no need to get hateful.
They're saying Jeanette. He's saying Marie. That's the one. So you've got Marie, Old McDonald, and Ronald McDonald. Now, you can take one of those or give us one of your own.
I left my boyfriend once. I can't do it again. I'm going to say Old McDonald.
With Charles. That was his answer. Okay, yes, she rejected him last time she was up here, and his answer was correct, and she did not choose it. So now she's choosing it, and this may not
remember
be the right
like
one.
Remember
one never knows, Carol. Here we go. Take my arm. We are looking for Old McDonald. Old McDonald, if you are under the $100 response, would you please reveal yourself? Jeanette McDonald. That was Brett's answer, I guess. So.
Thought of her. Marie will be there, don't worry.
I'll be calling you.
Didn't she do? Sweetheart, sweetheart, sweetheart. Didn't she do that with, what's his name?
Nelson Eddy.
With Nelson Eddy, right.
I'll be calling you 00000. Remember that one?
Here we go, looking for Old McDonald. May we see the $250 number? Old McDonald, you got it. Congratulations to you. How about that? You got another 250? What?
I know what the 500 is.
What?
Ryan McDonald. We forgot about him.
Ryan?
Who is he?
That's Tatum O'Neal.
They say Ronald McDonald. That's what the audience says. Let's see if they're right. Slide it, Earl.
Marie!
Ryan! Fanny had the answer. Okay. Well, anyway, you've picked up another $250. That means at this moment your cash total is $12,250. And you're going to play for 10 times $250 now, or $2,500. You know what you have to do to collect, so pick one.
Charles.
Charles, you ready?
Okay. Good luck.
He's so enthusiastic.
Okay.
$2,500? That's a lot of money. Here it is. Blank
instrument. Blank instrument. Charles has made up his mind, Carol. And now we ask you to make up your mind. What do you put in that blank in order to match him? Blank instrument.
Musical instrument.
Musical instrument is good. All right, Charles. $2,500 here at stake. She says that will match you.
I was hoping she had no one in the family in the medical profession. God knows what kind of instrument came out. But I'm very musical.
$14,750, and while she's celebrating, we'll pass these messages to you.
Today's consolation prizes are first, from Amity, a ladies' three-piece ensemble featuring the ultra-French purse, bills easily removed from hidden department to the change purse, Amity. And Foster Grant sunglasses with polarized mirror and gradient lenses. Foster Grant has everything. And from Kinney Shoes, a great American shoe store, a beautiful selection of fashion footwear. Kinney Shoes are with you every step of the way. And a shopper's tote from Parsons Ammonia. Freshens every room, walls to windows. Costs little, cleans a lot. Parsons, America's number one selling ammonia. Well, the boys stood on the burning deck, eating penis by the blank. And he grew up to be Gene Rayburn. When he continues in a minute.
Hello there.
I want at least three.
No. Oh, hello there. Let's all welcome Sharon Rich.
Ron. Hey, thank you.
How are you?
Fine, how are you?
Tell us where you're from, please.
I'm from a suburb of Buffalo, New York, called Amherst, and I'm married to a wonderful and famous policeman out there. I'm a lecturer for a weight reduction organization, and I've lost 107 pounds.
Oh!
Although I've kept it off for 7 years now.
So?
Yeah.
Is there a secret to that? Do you have a lot of willpower?
Oh, you sure do need a lot of willpower.
To keep it off.
Keep your big mouth shut.
And keep your big mouth shut, yeah. And now, you live in a suburb of Buffalo?
Buffalo, New York, where the cold snow is.
Yeah. And the town is called?
Amherst.
In Massachusetts, it's pronounced Amherst. The H is silent.
Oh, really?
Yeah. In New York State, they say Amherst.
Amherst. Yeah. That's my accent.
They talk M.
All right. Well, Sharon, we welcome you.
Thank you.
And we wish you the best of luck. And here we go. You may have a choice here, A or B.
B, please.
All right. Ready?
I was wondering, as Sharon's husband was a detective, did he ever find the 104 pound that you lost?
The 107 that you lost?
Seven. No, no. He's
now
didn't.
Living in a motel in Encino.
Here we go. On the subway,
yes.
Gloria said to the midget, wait till I read the question before I appreciate your enthusiasm, but cool it
little
until...
people find that
yes. Gloria said to the midget, hey, shorty, that's not the subway strap you're hanging on to. That's my blank.
Good.
Write something right now. Write something right now.
There are two terrific choices. I can't decide which one to go for.
Here's a... Why? Just came to me. Oh, the clear blue.
Out of the clear blue.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Charles would like to know who said it to whom.
Gloria said to the midget, that's shorty, that's not the subway strap you're hanging on to. That's my blank.
I got it already. I just wanted to hear you say this.
Oh, I'm sorry. I see your light is on. Is your light on? Okay.
My light's always on.
Sharon Rich, on the subway, Gloria said to the midget, hey, shorty, that's not the subway strap you're hanging on to. That's my blank.
Boob.
Really?
Is this your first time up?
This is her first time up.
She sounds
up
like a
for
pro.
What?
Right. What'd you say?
Very nice answer. Boom.
Oh. Somehow,
I really didn't expect that to come up.
Or down, or whatever.
You didn't?
No.
What did you expect to come up?
I thought everybody would say something like, you know, girdle, or, you know,
belt.
He's a short guy, or bra strap, or something like that.
Oh, honey, I say anything to get you through the night. Boobette.
Oh, boobette. Charles, what'd you say?
I said, logically, a garter.
A garter, right.
I'm sorry.
No one wears garters anymore, Charles.
I do.
Oh,
he doesn't even wear socks.
He doesn't take the subway anymore.
Yeah, but he likes garters. He doesn't wear the socks, just the garters.
I want to ask that woman, she lose that all in one hunk, or was that over the period of your lifetime?
No, I lost it in 11 months' time.
Very good.
Oh, how depressing. Sharon, this is the only right answer. Purse strap. Well, sure it is. It's right there.
That's right. If she were standing there like that, you see, holding her purse, as we do, then the purse strap would be right there, and the midget would be there. Okay. What do you say?
I'm going to appeal to the judges, because I trust that she was not holding this in her hand. Bra. No.
Oh. No. What do you say, Fanny?
Just a second. What else would be in there, judges?
And you, my dear.
You know what I said, my dear.
Yes.
Yes.
What else could she say? So that means two for you, and yours is to come, but now this is coming your way. Goody, goody for all of you. Thank you. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time. Match Game 76. Goodbye.
Speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.